It's the end of the year, which is the perfect time to test smartphone cameras. In this episode of Last Cam Standing, Google's Pixel 4 battles Apple's iPhone 11 Pro, Samsung's Galaxy Note 10 Plus, and Huawei's P30 Pro. Stay tuned to see which smartphone takes the best photos in 2019. Last Cam Standing is my long-running smartphone camera testing series that now has a new home here on TechAdvisor. For previous episodes, head to PC World's channel, but just know that I've tweaked the series a bit since last time. The goal of this video is simple. I'm trying to find out which of these phones can take the best photos. Each company tunes their hardware and software in specific ways, and I want to see what results we can get from the most basic of tests. To keep it simple, I'll only be looking at the results from the main lens of each camera, and I'll be using the default auto mode. It's the mode that 99% of us use day to day, and it's where companies do their most unique tuning. Now, of course, you can get more out of each camera by using third-party apps and capturing in pro mode, but I know I can take a good photo. I'm more interested to find out what the phone thinks is a good photo. I'll be breaking the results into three categories: color, clarity, and exposure. Along the way, we'll learn a lot about how these cameras perform, and at the end, I'll crown a winner. Now, let's meet the contestants. First is the Pixel 4, and with it, Google has finally quit being so stubborn and added a second camera to the back of its smartphone. To be honest, I would have rather had a wide-angle lens as opposed to a telephoto, but hey, it's a start. Next is the iPhone 11 Pro. Like Google, Apple has finally added another camera, a move they think makes it the most pro phone they have ever made. We'll see. Up next is the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Samsung has been coasting lately when it comes to the camera department, so I'm curious to see how it holds up to the stiff competition. And finally, we have Huawei and its P30 Pro. I'm pretty sure plenty of you are wondering why I didn't include the Mate 30 Pro in this fight, and here's why. First off, Huawei told us that they can't legally ship a Mate 30 Pro to me in the US. Secondly, if they did send one, I couldn't in good conscience recommend anyone use the damn thing without Google services built in. So even if it has the best camera in the world, it doesn't matter. I would rather focus on a phone I could recommend, which leaves us with the P30 Pro. Before we start, I want to give a shout out to our wonderful model, Victoria. I've linked to her Instagram in the description below, please go check it out. And with that, let's get to the testing. First up is color, and here I'm looking for things like color reproduction and accurate white balance. This first shot of Victoria is a simple one, but tells us the same classic story. Pixel phones tend to be the coolest, so no surprise there. iPhones tend to lean warmer, so that tracks here as well. The P30 Pro leans a bit on the cooler side, but has a curious green tint to her skin that makes her look kinda sick. But it's the Note 10 Plus that I think has the best balance of warm and natural colors here. The same thing plays out in many more of these photos, but this wider shot clues us into something interesting. We can now see the model's black jeans, which appear to be bluish in the Note 10's photo, even though her skin and sweater are still on the warmer side. The rest of the cameras keep her jeans darker, with only the Pixel's image having a hint of blue as well. In this example, I prefer the balance of the hues going on in the Pixel's photos, even though it is a bit on the cooler side. This next photo reveals the same problem for the Samsung phone. It's showing her black top to have far more blue in it than there actually was. It's even apparent on the gray steps behind her, and it's a curious trait. I'd prefer the warmer nature of the iPhone's photo in this one, and luckily Apple has corrected the horrible reddish hue found in skin tones over the past few years. I would have to go with the iPhone's version in this capture as well. The yellow leaves and splashes of sun lend themselves to a warmer tone, leaving the Pixel lacking punch. But the cool and muted P30 Pro shot is definitely the least pleasing overall, unless you're looking for something very stylized. This photo on the lawn actually has the Pixel skew warmer than the iPhone, which is an interesting twist. And if you look at the colors on the blanket, it's a bit more vibrant in the iPhone's photo and flat in Samsung's version. The P30 Pro's muted take on the scene feels pretty natural though, and in terms of color, it strikes the best balance for me. I would say the exact same thing for this photo. It's wild to see the Pixel turn in a warmer result than the iPhone. The iPhone's photo is also the most muted of the bunch, a wild swing from the other results in this category. But to be fair, based off the white wall, the iPhone is turning in a more accurate white balance reading. I lean towards preferring the Pixel's version here thanks to a warmer fall feel, but the P30 Pro would be a close second. So we are generally seeing consistent trends from each company in color reproduction, even despite a few odd variances. In general, the iPhone leans warmer, the Pixel leans cooler, Samsung and Huawei sit somewhere in the middle, but Huawei is usually the most muted. While all these phones are strong contenders, for me it's between the Pixel and the Note 10 Plus. The Samsung phone is probably the safest option, typically producing pleasing colors with healthy amounts of vibrance, but I personally put a bit more stock into accuracy, and I think the Pixel 4 retains the most accurate range of colors. It's not a huge win, but the color category goes to Google's Pixel 4. Now before I head into the next category, I want to know which phone you preferred. Hit the subscribe button if you want more camera testing videos like this, and after the video, head to the comments to argue the results. But there is still plenty of testing to be done, so let's keep going. The next category is clarity. And here I'm looking at the sharpness of each camera and how well they stay sharp in various lighting conditions. This example in a local brewery is up first and shows us a few things right off the bat. Once we zoom in, we can see how soft the Note 10's photo is compared to the others. Also notice the stair-stepping produced by the P30 Pro's 40-megapixel sensor that's pixel-binned to 10-megapixel. It's a clear enough shot, but it lacks fine detail thanks to the downscaling. If you look at the wood slats, it's the iPhone that has the most information present without too much grain. Moving to a photo with Victoria and focusing on the wood panel behind her, we see the same results. The iPhone just has the clearest photo. But if you focus on her skin, it's apparent that Apple isn't heavy-handed the way Google is with their noise reduction. But I am a bit stunned by the poor performance of the Samsung camera. It's once again the softest of the bunch. Moving closer to Victoria yields some interesting results. Looking at the background, we see far more bokeh in the P30 Pro's photo, and I'm not sure why. Yes, it does have a wider aperture and a larger sensor, but I'm not sold on the idea that we would be getting that much blur naturally from this camera. I wonder if there's a bit of depth processing going on in auto mode like there is in portrait mode. But that's a topic for a whole other video. Back to the matter at hand, let's focus on Victoria's eyelashes. The iPhone 11 Pro has the most definition, followed closely by the P30 Pro. It's not until we get about 6 feet away from our subject that we see the Pixel keep up with the iPhone. But it's still the iPhone that has the clearest capture, especially when you look at Victoria's pupils. Unfortunately, I can't fully explain the horrible performance from the Note 10 Plus, but it's most likely due to the heavy noise reduction algorithms. And how does that noise reduction work out for the Note 10 in dark situations? Well, here in my garage, when we zoom in, we see that yes, Samsung really doesn't like grain in its photos, and it hurts the overall clarity in every situation. But look at the iPhone result. It easily has the clearest photo of them all, with only a touch of grain present. The P30 Pro and its RYYB sensor does in fact let in plenty of light, and comes in at second place. Really, it's the Pixel 4 that's disappointing. But you might be asking, what about night mode? It's supposed to be Google's secret weapon and it should do the best here. Well, it did let in a lot of light, but when we zoom in, we find splotchy results. Somehow Apple has been able to leapfrog Google to have clearer low light photos in auto mode and night mode. Let's check out one more low light result from auto mode, this time in the darkest corner of the garage I could find. Here we find it's the P30 Pro that not only has the brightest photo, but the clearest as well. Looking at the fire extinguisher, we can make out a great amount of detail from Huawei's capture. I'm impressed. Switching to the night mode versions, it provides a huge bump for the rest of the cameras. The P30 Pro oddly didn't get that much better the way the rest of them did, but it still hangs. The iPhone once again has the best shot when it comes to low light and makes me highly jealous as an Android user. So we can wrap up this round as there isn't much of a contest here. Apple's iPhone 11 Pro easily wins the clarity category. The last category is exposure. And here I'm looking for correct exposures and a good balance of dynamic range. In this first example, we can immediately see that the Pixel continues its tendency to expose darker than the rest, and that the P30 Pro's HDR didn't fire properly. Typically, Samsung tends to brighten exposures, especially when there's a person in frame, but I'm happy to report that they have scaled that back here. The iPhone's photo is starting to clip out the highlights in the cloud and the wall behind Victoria. The Pixel has the most dynamic range, but the Note 10 is the more pleasing exposure. This backlit scenario is intentionally brutal for these cameras, and they each handle it a bit differently. The goal is to keep the subject properly exposed while not blowing out too much of the trees in the background. The Pixel underexposes the scene like usual, but the Note 10 retains just as much information in the branches. The iPhone pushes it a bit too far, and the P30 Pro continues to obviously stumble. I think the best balance here comes from the Note 10 Plus. The P30 Pro does better in this next high contrast example, and I'd actually say it did the best here. The exposure is right where I would like it, and the sidewalk isn't clipping highlights as much as the iPhone's capture. The underexposed version from the Pixel is just too dark, and the Samsung photo feels a bit too processed. In this shot, Victoria's face is too dark in the Pixel's version for my taste, and it didn't even retain as much highlight information compared to the Note 10's shot. The iPhone's photo is nice, but I do think it's Samsung's capture that does the best at walking the fine line between dynamic range and a proper exposure. Now let's look at some examples without a person as a subject, and we see a slightly different story. The Note 10 is the brightest of the bunch and exhibits some ugly flaring around the windows. The iPhone also has some rogue flares smearing across the frame. The P30 Pro does better than earlier in this round, and it retains the most information in the window frames, but it's slightly darker compared to the rest. And in this next one, it's the Pixel's photo that is the darkest. It also doesn't keep as much highlight information in the window as the Note 10, but the iPhone did even worse, and you can barely see a glimpse of the building on the other side. The P30 Pro does well again, but it's the Note 10 that does the best overall, holding plenty of information in the shadows and the highlights without feeling washed out. At the end of the day, I'm very impressed by how well the Note 10 has improved over the S10. In the previous episode of Last Cam Standing, the S10 was overexposing shots all over the place. But here, the Note 10 does a great job at capturing pleasing exposures. So it's Samsung's Galaxy Note 10 Plus that takes the exposure category. Well, to wrap it up, what's the takeaway? Honestly, I had to dig real deep to find examples of major differences between these cameras. A majority of the hundreds of photos I took have very minimal differences between them. If you were lucky enough to have any of these flagship phones, you're going to get great shots 90%+ of the time. And if you're like me and know how to get the most out of your camera, then you're in an even better spot. But you don't want a fluffy conclusion. You want me to take a stand and declare a winner, don't you? Well, if there was one camera I could have in my pocket, it would be Apple's iPhone 11 Pro. Not only did it dominate in the clarity category, it held its own in the other categories as well, and is an all-around great shooter. But since I'm not an iPhone user, I do want to pick a second place between the three Android phones. And in that case, I would have to reach for Samsung's Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Sure, it stumbled hard in the clarity category, but it did well in color and won the exposure category. Add on top of that, the Note 10 has more cameras and a deeper app experience than the Pixel 4, making it the obvious Android choice for me. So what do you think? Am I selling the Pixel 4 too short? Sound off in the comments below and be sure to subscribe for more episodes of Last Cam Standing here on Tech Advisor.